Hi, welcome back to our YouTube channel. Today I'm going to show you a review of a pen that I found, and it was an unusual find, in my opinion. This pen, maybe this box already reminds you of something. This pen was found at the same store where I found this Osama pen that I already reviewed. And like the Osama, this is a new old stock pen. And so let's show you. And this pen is a Lamy pen. And here it is. So first of all, it was a very I didn't know about anything about this model. I didn't know it even existed. But when I got to the store, and I was seeing the pens they had, I looked and I saw, what is that? It immediately, looking at this part, it immediately reminded me of a Lamy 2000. It is not a Lamy 2000, but it had something similar, and I had to know more about it, and I even bought it. So, this pen is the Lamy 20. Let me show you. The model is Lamy 25P. And let's take a look at the outside of the pen and show you how it is. First of all, the top of the cap is made of metal, the same metal as the clip, which is very, very nice, very springy. The cap is made of a black plastic material, which I'm almost sure is the same Macrolon used with the Lamy 2000. And here on the cap lip, as I showed you, it says Lamy 25P and then West or W Germany, which means this pen was made prior to the fall of the Berlin Wall. And for what I researched in the internet, this pen was made around 1976. The barrel is made of metal. Because it is so light, I would say this is aluminum and not steel. I'm almost sure of that. And it has a black finial on the barrel that tapers down a little, very similar to the Lamy shape, to the Lamy 2000 shape, and then it says L from Lamy. And what else? Then we will uncap the pen. And the pen uncaps just by pulling the cap. As you can see, it has. Let me show you closer. It has a plastic rim here between the barrel and the section, and it has these little metal things that are very similar to the ones in the Lamy 2000 that hold the cap in place. Then it has a plastic section, which is definitely not the same plastic as in the cap. And you may see this is like ABS plastic, and this really looks like that brushed version of Macrolon. Then the section has this shape, and the nib is a semi-hooded inlaid nib. It's hard to describe this, and when you look from the underside, it really looks like a Lamy 2000. So, quite interesting profile, and it says here on the section, and I think you can see it, extra fine. When I saw these, then I remembered, okay, I have a pen that reminds me of this one that I bought at the flea market here in Lisbon some time ago. And when I got home, I checked, and this is the other one I got at the flea market, and this is another Lamy. The Lamy want to show you 68. And when we uncap this pen, a little different capping system, you can see that the shape of the section and the nib are exactly the same. However, this pen is a piston filler and this one is a cartridge filler. But it was interesting to see this design and to realize that I had something that similar at home and I didn't remember. These are some of those my purchases that are not very well thought before, and when I discover things I buy them and then try to figure out more information about them. Then they unscrew and they have the barrel unscrews. It has a different color plastic threads here that screw on the black plastic threads inside of the metal barrel. And the interesting part of this pen, it doesn't take the Lamy proprietary cartridges, it takes international cartridges. So it can take a long or two short international cartridges. However, I didn't try the long. I don't know if this tapers down too much to have room for a long, I'm not sure, but it takes at least the short international cartridges, which it was quite surprising. I didn't know that were Lamy is made with international cartridges. And this is all. The pen is very, very light, it's extremely light. The cap is made of plastic, the barrel is metal, but I believe it is aluminum, so it is very, very light. There is something that appeals me about the pens with this kind of shape from this era. And here you have a Pelican P476. And a Montblanc Carrera, and as you may see, there are some similarities. This one is aluminum, this one is steel, metal, plus macrolon metal, and this is plastic also. The same overall shape of the clip, here it is a little different, it has no holes, that one has roughly the Pelican shape. And then when you uncap these pens, they all have what I consider to be somewhat similar nibs, like semi-hooded nibs, and they are not aesthetically my favorite ones, but I have to say that I really enjoy to see these and I find them like ugly ducklings. They are not the prettiest, but I can't avoid to like them. So this is very interesting. About the size comparison, let's see it against other pens. The first pen we have to compare it with is the Lamy 2000, which is bigger and girthier. And here you have also the Parker Centennial Dufold and the Lamy All-Star. So this is more slim and thinner than the other two. Here it is, the comparison between this pen and the Lamy 2000. Okay, they are really not the same pen, but they are quite similar in their style. This one has the same size as the Lamy 2000 in length, and then with the Parker Dufold uncapped and the Lamy All-Star uncapped. So as you can see, it has a decent size in what considers the length. It's not so thick as the other ones, but it is quite a nice pen to use. It also has this nice thing that pens from this era almost all had. is the cap going, posting quite deeply. So the balance is perfect. It's one of those pens. For me, the reference is the Parker 45 that post like this very deeply and they become very well balanced posted. So this is one of the few that goes to the to that family of pens that I enjoy to post when writing. So now let's see the writing test. And here we are with the our usual Rhodia dot pad. The Lamy 25E and ink is Caveco Palm Green. So, about this pen and the writing experience, it is very well balanced, as I told you. About the nib, is a very fine nib. It is an extra fine nib, but I would say it is almost a modern extra fine nib. It's really fine. About the wetness, it's quite dry, but the pen writes well, as you can see. If it is, it has a stiff nib, but very smooth. You can write with this, and it is really smooth on paper, but it is quite stiff. However, you can always try to have some line variation, and if you press a little bit harder, you can open the tines a little bit and have more ink on the paper. I don't really know if the line is really thicker or if it is m the a bigger amount of ink, and I really think it's both that happen. So, if I do this, it is quite dry. If I do this with a little bit more strength, as you can see, a lot more ink is put on paper. If you do this, it goes from an extra fine to a fine nib. About writing upside down, it writes, and it writes even finer, but it is scratchy, so I don't really advise you to do that. About the writing, this pen has the nib is quite well polished, and it is not scratchy in all these regular positions. But about writing, it has a sweet spot. If you turn it too much, it won't write anymore because it starts skipping. So you have to keep the pen straight on the paper. And this is it. This is the line variation you can get. It is a very interesting pen. It's not very easy to find online. I found these, and they had some more variations. I don't remember now one that had more silver color and other one that was pink, which was very strange to find this Lamy designing pink, and I started to imagine how would a pink Lamy 2000 look like, and it was a strange thought. I'm not that much into pink pens, however, I have a couple of pink Caveco pens and Lamy. So let's finish this review. It is long enough. I hope you like this. I'll try to make the videos a little bit shorter. Thank you for watching. I hope you liked it. If you did, please subscribe our YouTube channel and keep coming here to watch more videos like this. See you next time. Bye.